After Jose Aldo's performance against Rob Font, a huge topic got brought up among the fans. Who is a greater fighter? Jose Aldo or Khabib Nurmagomedov? When you talk about greatest fighters of all time, it always comes down to the subjective criteria that differs between each person. Everybody looks at greatness in a different lens. Some people look at title defenses as a major component to determine who is the greatest of all time. Some people look at knockouts, performances, who revolutionized the sport, who's the most famous, who makes the most money. Everybody looks at greatness in a different way. So it's important to make the distinction that there is no concrete answer as to who is greater in Jose Aldo or Khabib if we don't have the criteria down first. So I'm going to list the competitive achievements that both these fighters created in their careers. The thing that gives Khabib an edge over most fighters was how dominant he was in his career, and the fact that he was also undefeated. He only lost 2 rounds of his entire MMA career. He's never been cut, he's never bled, he's never been bruised up, always came out of the fights as a dominating force. That is the ultimate thing that makes Khabib great. Yes, he's beating great competition. Yes, he has that long win streak, but when you talk about level of competition, when you talk about longevity at the top of the game, when you talk about title defenses and other title accolades, those are the areas that Khabib doesn't really compare that well to some of the greatest fighters of all time. Because where he has the dominating factors on his side, Jose Aldo has the title accolades. He has the overall level of competition. He has the longevity at the top of MMA. So Jose Aldo's fought at the WEC and the UFC for 13 and a half years. That's 27 fights total. Khabib's fought in the UFC for almost 9 years. Khabib has 13 fights in the UFC. That's a very different level of longevity in their two careers. And yes, Jose Aldo has lost, but the difference is Aldo was a champion for most of the time he was in the UFC and WEC. So the level of competition that Jose Aldo had to beat on a consistent basis was a lot more difficult than what Khabib had to beat. Because as a champion, you're always fighting the next best guy. Khabib didn't have to do that until the very end of his career. So Khabib has exactly 4 title wins, 3 title defenses. He was a champion for 2.5 years. Jose Aldo had 11 title wins, 9 title defenses, and was a champion for overall in his 2 runs as a champion for 8 years. Pretty much showing to be 3 times the champion Khabib was. And I understand a lot of people are going to say that Jose Aldo was given the UFC title, he never won it. I will cover that after we talk about the level of competition. So the best fighters that Khabib fought, and I'm going to categorize them in great wins to good wins. His great wins were Dustin Poirier, Conor McGregor, Justin Gaethje, and Rafa dos Anjos. His good wins consist of Michael Johnson, Edson Barboza, Ally Quinta, and Gleison Tibau. Jose Aldo's great wins are Frankie Edgar twice, Chad Mendez twice, Uriah Faber, Rob Font, Korean Zombie, and Mike Brown. Jose Aldo's good wins consist of Pedro Munhoz, Marlon Vera, Renato Moicano, Jeremy Stevens, Ricardo Lamas, Kenny Florian, Mark Hominick, and Cub Swanson. You can see the difference. So when we lay it all out, we can see that if you look at a dominant fighter to be the greatest, then Khabib is definitely going to be greater than Jose Aldo. Jose Aldo was not dominating opponents the way Khabib was, especially high-level competition. He lost many more rounds than Khabib, he came out of fights way more banged up, and he never looked as unstoppable. But if you look at pretty much everything else, who had the better title accolades, who had the better competition, who was doing it for longer, who fought multiple different generations, all of those go to Jose Aldo. So it is subjective, it depends how you want to look at it, but in my opinion, I think Jose Aldo is greater than Khabib. Because in my criteria, the level of competition, title accolades, and longevity are more important than domination in specific fights. And level of competition, in my opinion, is the most important thing because it makes up everything. It's the foundation that gives credibility to any other kind of criteria. Who you beat is the most important because it explains your domination, it explains your longevity, explains your win streaks. How good really were your title defenses? How much did they actually matter? Who did you beat in your title wins? And then be able to fight that level of competition over years as a champion, in my mind, that's what ultimately makes up greatness in a fighter. The thing that hurts Khabib more than anything in terms of greatness is the fact that he retired so young. He retired before he can beat everybody in the division. An attempt to stay at the top, continue his championship run the way Jose Aldo did. Right, Khabib had a 13-fight win streak in the UFC. On his 10th win, he won the title. He defended only 3 times, and then he retired. That is the equivalent of Jose Aldo retiring after he beat the Korean Zombie. If you're talking about by the 13th win, he would have retired after he beat the Korean Zombie. He would never have fought Lamas. He wouldn't have fought Mendez a second time. He wouldn't have lost to Conor. He wouldn't have lost to Max Holloway. Alexander Volkanovski never would have been at 135. And Aldo would have ended his career as a dominating force in the featherweight division where nobody came close to beating him. Not quite as dominant as Khabib, but still extremely dominant altogether. It looked like nobody was going to touch him. That is not that different of a narrative to the narrative Khabib has right now. But Aldo did not do that. He continued his career and he fought the next generation of fighters. He fought the younger guys like Max Holloway and ultimately started to lose. And that's ultimately what Khabib never had to deal with in his entire career. He never fought the younger generation. Jose Aldo did, and he lost to them, as most fighters lose to the younger generation. Khabib has never had to deal with facing that level of competition. And that's ultimately the thing here. Now, a lot of people will say that Jose Aldo was given the UFC title and never had to win it the way Khabib did. Well, number one, he did win the UFC title back when he fought Frankie Edgar at UFC 200. But considering the WEC days, it's weird how a lot of people see it this way. They never look at it as Jose Aldo actually fought his way to the title. A lot of people like to throw away the WEC, when the WEC was essentially the UFC. It was pretty much the same thing. You could think of it as a branch from the UFC that held the smaller divisions. Because he absolutely fought his way to get that WEC title. He had to have 5 wins in a row before he fought the champion Mike Brown. And after fighting his way to the featherweight title, he was handed it in the UFC because the organization did not have a featherweight division. Transferring the WEC fighters to the UFC was a resumption for them to continue their careers. It was like nothing changed for them. If they didn't give Aldo the title, who would have fought for it? Jose Aldo would have fought Mark Hominick for the vacant title, another WEC fighter, and the same thing would have happened. The only featherweights that were in the UFC at that time were from the WEC. So yes, Jose Aldo did win the title, and he defended it 9 times. Khabib only defended it 3 times. And yes, Khabib had to fight more than Jose Aldo to get to that title, but it didn't have to happen the way it did. Khabib could have fought for the title sooner than he did. Because remember, Khabib was continuously injured in his career. There was a point in time where Khabib missed out 2 years, and even contemplated retirement after the RDA fight. And that RDA went and set him up to a title shot. When he made his return against Daryl Horcher, he had to build himself back up. He got 2 more wins after that and then fought for the title. And there's also another thing. Khabib has missed weight before. He's had a couple weight cutting issues. So he could have actually had a title shot with a similar amount of wins that Jose Aldo had. It's just that Jose Aldo never got injured. He never had a long layoff. He never missed weight. He fought as often as possible. And where Jose Aldo dominated one division, he's looking to dominate another one. He's now at bantamweight and just beat 2 contenders in that division, has established himself as a top 4 fighter, where he's continuously racking up more quality wins. And that is why I say that in terms of competition beaten, Jose Aldo is overall ahead of Khabib. So yes, Khabib beat Dustin Poirier, Justin Gaethje, Conor McGregor, Rafa dos Anjos. Those are some great wins for him, but it's just that he hasn't beaten a lot of these great or good fighters. And everything else is not really comparable. He beat great fighters, and Dustin Poirier may be the greatest win out of both fighters' careers. Frankie might be somewhat comparable to that. And overall, Aldo has beaten more great and good fighters than Khabib has. So with everything summed up, you could determine for yourself who is greater than who. Khabib is an anomaly in greatness talk because he's been the most dominant force in specific fights and he's undefeated. But when you try to be as objective as possible in terms of the other things he's done in his career, they don't hold up to most of the other great fighters. It all comes down to his domination in his career. That's what it all comes down to, man. And if that's not enough for him to be greater than Jose Aldo, then nothing else is going to make him greater. In my GOAT list, Khabib would be probably number 5. And I would have to put Aldo as either number 4 or number 3.